Some people believe in psychics. They believe that they're not real. Some people swear by them. He has joined us before and completely made me a believer, and now he's back for round two. Psychic medium Matt Fraser joins us, and there's a cruise involved that's coming up at 9:30. Now, when a loved one or friend passes away, it is a very difficult time. We all long for getting another chance to connect or communicate. Our next guest has that very real ability. He's a medium. He is Matt Fraser. Let's take a look.
I'm doing everything for her and helping her. She does show me here, thank you so much, thank you so much. She keeps saying it to me. She says, you are like an angel to her. She says, thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for being there for her. She keeps also showing me here, you wetting her lips is what comes up. Did you wet her lips? Do you understand that? Because, and at the end, she like couldn't talk. And she says, I'm so sorry. She says, because you witnessed so much. She says, you witnessed so much there, and she didn't want you to see all that happened and all that was around. You understand that? Because your mom was a very private person, is what I keep seeing. She didn't like anybody to see her sick. She didn't like anybody to see her not well.
And here he is in the flesh, Matt Fraser. Welcome back to the show, shall I say.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Absolutely. Now, how did you first know that you had these type of powers?
Well, when I first grew up, I want to say I was about three or four years old when I first started to see dead people. And for me, it was like living that movie, The Sixth Sense. I'd go to bed and literally I was afraid. Seeing dead people was much scarier in real life than what you see on TV, right, or what you see on movies. When I was a kid, I wanted nothing to do with it. I wanted to push it away because I didn't see it as a gift at that time. I saw it as a curse.
Now, was anybody in your family aware of these powers or had these powers? How did you deal that with your family?
So my grandmother was a medium. But back in the day when she had this gift, you couldn't talk about it. You couldn't say, I'm a medium, or I see dead people, or I, you know, can speak to those who had passed on. It was something that they pushed away and they kept away from everybody. And my grandmother actually kept it so secret, Michael, that not even my grandfather knew that she did it. Wow. And my mom also had the gift, and then it was passed on to me. And I was the first person in my family who actually decided to run with it later on in life.
What do you say to critics out there? Because obviously there are a lot of critics. I didn't believe in it, but then we had a tremendous experience the last time you were here with me. What do you say to people who doubt these powers?
I don't think you can doubt it until you experience it. I think it's perfectly normal to be a skeptic. And I love the skeptical ones,
yeah,
especially when I first came on the show and I first met you, because I think it's the people who don't want to believe and the people who don't believe in the other side, who don't believe in an afterlife, those are the people I need to talk to. And those are the people that need to be at one of my events or needs to be at one of my shows, because it's the person who doesn't believe that sometimes can have a life-changing experience by hearing from a loved one on the other side.
Now, are you religious in any way?
I'm spiritual.
You're spiritual.
I grew up Catholic. But now that I'm older, I believe in all different religions. I think that religion is just a way to have a conversation with your loved ones on the other side, and all religions are beautiful. They're just a special way for you to connect.
Yes. So you have a big event coming up where people can actually experience this. The holidays are coming up. Now, do the spirits kind of wake up during the holiday seasons and leave signs for people who want to connect with them during those holidays? I know those were very memorable moments probably that you had with mom or dad. What happens during these holiday seasons?
Okay, so the signs are always around us. They're always there. But during the holiday season, that's the time when we're thinking about our loved ones. So it's the times when we receive these signs that we kind of pay more attention to them. And the signs can be anything. It can be, I like to tell people that whatever you think is a sign probably is. If it makes you remember your loved one and think about your loved one, then it's a sign. It could be a familiar song that you hear. You know, there's some people that actually smell their loved ones, whether it be their grandmother's Gina Tay that they smell or their dad's Old Spice who had passed away. It could be finding pennies and dimes from heaven if your dad was a coin collector. There's many different ways that they use to communicate and to reach us and to let us know that they're close by. It's just that we have to open up our minds here in this world.
What is that cruise going to look like?
So I'm taking everybody on a 7-day psychic odyssey cruise, because people come to me for many different reasons. They come to me not only to connect with the other side, but also to go and open up their own psychic ability. So I'm going to be taking people on the Holland America line, where you'll join me for 7 days. We're going to be doing group readings on board, helping you connect with your loved ones on the other side. It's going to be a spiritual awakening. We're going to be swimming with dolphins, visiting a butterfly observatory, but also doing meditations and classes to help you reach your loved ones and your higher self. Because I believe that we can all reach our loved ones and we can all communicate with them. It's just that we have to open ourselves up and find what way we can sense and feel them.
Are you saying that you believe we all have these powers?
Absolutely. And especially through dreams. Have you ever had a dream of a loved one that had passed on? Those dreams are real. That's the easiest way. The best way, people always ask me, well, how do you describe what you do? The easiest way is dreaming while you're awake. That's what it's like for me. When I'm having a psychic vision, it's like dreaming. Yeah. And that's why most people, the way they connect with their loved ones is through a dream.
All right, Matt, thank you so much for joining us. Hopefully we can stick around and have an experience on our Facebook Live page. All right, you can learn more about Matt Fraser yourself by checking out his website, meetmattfraser.com. He's filled with a lot of information about him and his upcoming events. We'll have more with Matt, like I said, on that Facebook extra. Thank you very much. We're back with Matt Fraser, a spiritual medium, with a quick reading. I'm doing this for all of the skeptics out there. Matt, let's get it cracking, should we say.
So listen, the last time I was here, you heard from a friend of yours that had passed.
Yes.
But the thing is that when I read people, it's funny how one day you can hear from one person and the next day you can hear from somebody different. And today when I walked into the studio, your grandmother was here with you. But then she was also pushing forward another young male that had passed very, very quickly. So that was another friend of yours?
Okay. Yes. Yes.
So know that it's his way of allowing me to know that he's stepping forward from the other side. He actually just shows me that there was balloons let off into the air within his memory. Do you understand that?
Oh, yes.
Were you a part of that?
Yes, I was.
Because he said he wants to thank you for the balloons that you let off. And more importantly, that his family was there. And thank you so much for the support that you had given to them. He's acknowledging when I'm speaking to him. A lot of times you're very lucky that he's coming through, because normally it takes a year's time for somebody to step forward. And I know he was a recent passing. But this is because of the fact that he's trying to get through to his parents. A lot of times the souls on the other side will use us to communicate messages.
Yes.
And what he's saying is about the fact that he had an underlying medical condition here in the physical world. He shows me that they were bringing him from doctor to doctor to doctor, and that they were bringing him for second opinions here in the physical world, trying to give him the opportunity to live. Do you understand that?
Yes. Absolutely.
He also was showing me there was some type of an infection that was going on at the same time, because he's showing me blood issues that were happening as well.
Yes.
So know it's his way of acknowledging that he's free from all of that. He says that he wants to thank his parents for the way that they allowed him to feel as though that nothing was wrong his entire life, and that they made him feel as though he was every other kid here in the physical. He says, and I want to thank them for that, because I did not live my life in pain. He says, I lived with knowing the love that my parents gave me and watching my parents fight for me. He says, I will always be grateful for that.
Absolutely, that is phenomenal.
So who was that to you?
You know, recently I went to a funeral a week or 2 weeks ago. John Paul, who lives in West Palm Beach, it was a young kid who passed at 20, I think he was like 22 years old. He had a heart condition from birth. He wasn't supposed to live. And he lived 20 plus years. He went to college. He changed lives his whole life. His parents became friends of mine just out of the blue, and we just had this great relationship.
But wait a minute.
And that was phenomenal.
He's also telling me that there was a scholarship in memory of him.
That will be in the works. Yes.
Are you working on that?
His mom is. His mom just called me and said that they wanted to get a foundation started for memory of him. Matt, thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
For joining us today. Wow. You can learn more about Matt Fraser yourself by checking out his website, meetmattfraser.com.